My name is Madeline.
Hi, my name is Pi.
Hi, I'm Emma.
I have to write a paper for school that has something to do with Maine history.
I think I'm going to write about how mills impacted the Maine watershed.
A watershed is all of the land area from which a storm runoff drains into a body of water.
This could be any water that is not absorbed into the earth.
It rolls over the ground until it hits more water, like a lake or river, and eventually empties into the ocean.
This means that storm water travels across land and picks up all the pollutants on the ground before it travels all the way to the Maine coast.
Natural vegetation helps runoff flow to places where it can be absorbed into the ground instead of flowing to the ocean.
But the more land is developed with things like roads, buildings, and agricultural fertilizers, the more pollutants are picked up and the less natural vegetation there is to deter runoff.
Let's see. What are some watershed regions in Maine?
Hey, Androscoggin River.
I've heard of that.
The Androscoggin watershed is 164 miles long. It starts in Errol, New Hampshire, in the White Mountains, and eventually connects with the Kennebec River at Merry Meeting Bay in Brunswick before it travels to the Atlantic Ocean.
I wonder how a factory being so close to a river could impact the watershed.
Wouldn't it be cool if I could talk to someone who used to work in one of those old mills?
Whoa, 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 what's going on? Whoa!
Do you know what the funny thing is about work? You keep doing it every day for years and years, nonstop, and for what? Accumulating amounts of money? It's silly, really, working yourself into a tailspin in order to make a living. I've noticed this whole world revolves around what we can buy and sell, and there is no way to be happy without spending. Try to find a job that pays good money, maybe you've fallen on hard times and need a boost, only to trade away the profits you earn. And with the rise and fall of the natural resources that people use to buy, trade, sell, or use, your job has to be one that can pick you up when those natural resources aren't there. Take those big, booming mills they've got by the riverside. With their smoky, rancid stench, gargantuan size, you need to secure to get the month's pay. Their levers and turning wheels, you have to keep going to keep that pay. You know, soon I'm gonna have to work over at that textile mill. See? I'm the oldest in my family, my sisters being 5 and 7 years younger than me, but I've never had to work before. I'm only 14. When I told my mother that, she only laughed. That same morning, my father and I went fishing. My father and I always catch a good haul down by the river, but this morning was different. Less than half of what we usually get, and the fish we did manage to catch looked sickly. Best if we don't give your mother and sisters the chore of eating that, and he gestured to the scrawny, sunken-eyed fish. We didn't have much to eat that night. That's why I have to work in the mill. I have to make money to buy the fish down in the market instead of the meager amount down by the river. Father has a job, but I guess that isn't enough. My friend Mary and I, just 2 days ago, we were hanging out with her older brother and his friends. They've started working a lumber mill in the next town over, and according to them, there's a rumor between the sudden pop-up of the textile and lumber mills and the drop of fish in the river. Now, I don't know much about what they're pumping out of those mills, but I do know it isn't good.
Whoa, did you see that? That was crazy. This must be some type of time travel device.
But I learned the fish in rivers were dying and the fish that remained were sick and inedible. That meant that Mainers had to buy their fish at the market instead of fishing for themselves, which required women and girls to get jobs so they could pay for the fish.
For over 200 years, the integrity of the watershed was compromised by mills and fishing development thanks to the Industrial Revolution. But today, many of these areas are able to support wildlife again. I think I can write my paper now.
How about you out there? What parts of Maine history are you curious about?
Where do you want to go next?